Greetings, greetings, Bill Nye here. I am so excited because the LightSail 2 spacecraft is still performing wonderfully. You know, we launched last summer and we got on orbit. It's amazing. Well, now we're still on orbit and we've got two fantastic cameras on board, and now we are getting these remarkable images. And I'd like to share a few of them with you. And so we have the head of our team, Dr. Bruce Betts. Take it, Bruce.
Thanks, Bill. The first image is actually a set of images showing the deployment of the sails. They start out folded up inside our loaf of bread-sized CubeSat spacecraft, but then we see the mylar shiny sail material deploying out to 32 square meters, which is about the size of a boxing ring.
Oh, I remember this moment when all we were getting were the data that showed that the booms were deployed. But there were no pictures, not for a while. But then the pictures came down. Back to you, Dr. B.
Next up, sunbeams over the western coast of India. This landmass down here is India. Mumbai is over this way, and then the southern tip of India is clearly visible right here. And the sun is actually behind the sail here, illuminating the backside and also bouncing off the Arabian Sea.
Oh man, I love this one. The sunlight is coming right through the sail. The sun is fantastically bright, you all. And the sail is fantastically thin. So when it's lined up just so, sunlight comes right through. It looks like the solar sail is coming right at you. Take it, Dr. Betts.
Moving north just a bit to the Himalayas. This is actually my personal favorite picture. This is all snow. It was a pretty clear day in the Himalayas, which was exactly why we chose to take a picture on this day. Tibet is up here, and Mount Everest is right about there. Now, it's important to note that our cameras are using very wide-angle fisheye lenses. That allows us to cover all the sail with two cameras. We've removed much of the distortion in this image, but some remains near the edges. Even with corrections, keep in mind that we're looking at 180 degrees, so one side of the image is the opposite direction of the other side of the image.
Oh yeah, these are wild. This looks like you're seeing the whole hemisphere of the Earth, but really we're at a relatively low altitude. As high as the spacecraft is, it's at a relatively low altitude. It's a fisheye lens, a very wide angle lens. You're not seeing the whole Earth, but you're seeing what looks like it. It's just spectacular.
Moving on to a nice view over Central Australia. You might have noticed something special here. This shadow on the sail is the shadow of the spacecraft. Our small CubeSat opens up to have four panels, like this. This, by the way, is a full-scale model. By looking at some of these images, we started to suspect that one of the panels wasn't fully deployed, more like this. We can only see the spacecraft by seeing the shadow, so it took some investigating.
So Dr. Betts got to thinking about this, and instead of creating some amazing computer program with all sorts of computer-aided design, computer-aided manufacturer-style elements, no, he got some cardstock, some pieces of paper, and a flashlight.
And sure enough, yes, one of our panels is not fully deployed, or to use a technical term, it is flopped over. We didn't plan on that. But the spacecraft's okay, and in fact, by figuring this out, we've been able to tune the orientation knowledge of our spacecraft based upon using the flopped over angle. Finally, let's move on to a stunning image of the Red Sea and the Nile River in Egypt.
I mean, those pictures are just stunning. They just get me every time. So thank you, Dr. Betts. Thank you indeed. And thank you to the 50,000 people around the world who just thought that solar sailing was a worthy use of our intellect and treasure. So here we all are quarantined with this extraordinary pandemic, but the spacecraft is still flying. It's still taking our dreams beyond the sky. We're learning more about outer space and our place within it, thanks to you. And with the spacecraft, which proved its mission, it's accomplished its mission, but we're also using its cameras to give everyone in the world what astronauts call the overview effect. Each of us is able to see the whole world. We're quarantined at home, but we can all share this experience. We are all citizens of the same planet in this extraordinary place in the extraordinary cosmos. Thank you all. Thanks for your support. Stay safe and we'll keep them flying.